Night had been a success for the leopard son. He now had the skills he'd need for life. Little did he know, his greatest tests were yet to come. Why did he leave his tree, hoping to make another kill? Ordinarily, trees gave him confidence, superiority. But there are still things he has to learn. He's either wildly overconfident or totally unaware she's climbed the tree. A reckless oversight. Now, only the thinnest of branches, the top of the tree, can save him. She's distracted by the presence of elephants. Lions sometimes kill small elephant calves, but adults fiercely protect their young. The sun's bad luck continues. He's lost a meal, but he'll learn it's far better to lose a carcass than to be one. This was the closest he'd come to losing his life. Suddenly he looked to me so lonely. And in that instant, the call of home was in the air. It was the companion of his youth. Thank you. Once the world is grasped, we all return home, one way or another. Home to the tree of life. It was his mother. She'd given birth to twins. She was a good mother. Even at 11 years old, she was in prime condition, and I felt she'd be able to raise her new son and daughter successfully. But as always, the urge to hunt meant leaving her cubs behind. Son, the call of home had been much greater than I thought. I was amazed. It's unknown for adult males to return to their mothers. Excited. No one has ever seen an adult brother confront his younger siblings before. But would he accept the twins? Lions kill cubs not related to them. But leopards? My only hope was that he'd recognize his mother's scent. And if he did, would that protect his brother and sister? For the first time in 2 years, I had no idea what he'd do.